I'm not going to let you bully that girl, Sue.
Oh, I bully everybody. Will is the way I roll.
Yeah, but this is different. She's not like everybody else.
I want you to listen to what you just said, William. You're asking me to treat this girl differently because she has a disability, when actually it seems to me she just wants to be treated like everybody else. Oh, I know you're furious, Will. But do you honestly believe anything I said was unreasonable?
Well, no.
There are limits, Will. There is a line. And for reasons I suspect have nothing to do with your kids, you crossed it. You can't yell fire in a crowded theater, and you can't expose kids to material like this. Not on the taxpayer's dime.
Oh, please, Sue. They have the internet. They are exposed.
Don't lead them to it. Don't make it okay. They're kids. And now more than ever, high school is a dangerous place, and it's our job to guide them through it safely.
To realize something, I am here for two very important reasons. Number one, Mr. Schuster needs at least one adult friend.
You do realize that Blurred Lines is a song about date rape, don't you?
What? No, it's not.
Will, you need to back your ass up to the fact that you, a married 37-year-old, just performed a song about coercive sexual advances as nine minors twerked alongside you down the hallways of a public high school.
I'm disturbed on every level. And Becky has been scarred for life.
Sue, I'm mortified.
We are so...
I am aware that the pheromones emitted from the orifices of your porous bird lady pelvis can cause an overwhelming urge to copulate in some emotionally stunted man children with butt chins who befriend teenagers and can't rap. But why could you not wait to copulate until you return to the sickly sweet stench of your own conjugal bed?
You have befouled the profession of teaching by accepting not only one, but two Teacher of the Year awards, despite not speaking a word of the foreign language you purport to teach.
Like the storied predators of yesteryear, Will. You pick only the most vulnerable students to favor, while actively neglecting the others. Like that gross kid with the dreadlocks, or that poor Irish idiot, Rory. Or the black dancer, whose name none of us remember. Because you rode his back to a win at sectionals and then promptly ignored him into oblivion. You positively worship a student if they can so much as carry a tune, and yet you don't know a single name of the only true musical geniuses in that choir room. The band! Who have demonstrated time and again that they can, at the drop of a hat, play literally any song you can name, and still you treat them like so much nameless human garbage. Your bizarre psychosexual obsession with that glee club was disturbing from the first moment you stalked a nude student in the showers. You know, I'm honestly surprised you didn't reenact what was clearly the formative event of your own teenage years and Sandusky, the poor kid right there and then. Oh, and I think those absorbent sweater vests actually hide the fact that you lactate every time you give one of your excruciatingly condescending pep talks. Your charms wore off a long time ago, William. Somewhere around Bieber Week.